spring that we are all currently going through. I would like to welcome Reverend Lee to start us off with a small opening. And first off, my name is
that dude is in it.
I am also one of the 11 documented people here. I'm unashamed, I'm unapologetic. I am a person, and I am not willing to stand anymore to see family separated. President Obama started misleading us, telling us that he had a vision of hope. And by seeing all these people here, he has not been held accountable to that vision. Every single day, we all stay worried up at night, thinking when we're going to see our other loved ones. 2 million too many have been deported, and we're here to tell everybody that we're not ready to do that anymore. We're going to fight, we're going to be strong, and we're going to unite because we have power.
¡Bravo! ¡Bravo!
Una líder de Exopecia. Y les quiero agradecer mucho por estar acá. Mucho porque hoy en este día vamos a dejar saber a nuestro presidente y a nuestro congreso que ya no vamos a ser, ya no vamos a ser ignorados, que nos han causado mucho dolor. Y nosotros sabemos el dolor y ellos no nos quieren escuchar. Pero no es que ya no quieran, es que los vamos a hacer que nos escuchen. Gracias por estar aquí. Y vamos, porque ¿saben qué? La gente tiene poder, y el poder puede mucho.
¡Claro que sí!
We won't stand for them being torn apart from us anymore.
No!
Dos millones por muchos.
We ask your blessing on all those who are here and those who could not make it and those who are in court today and those who are being deported today. Let them know that we are with them, that our solidarity is with them, and together, juntos, vamos a parar estas deportaciones.
Dos millones por muchos.
Amén, amén, en H.
Amén.
Representa a todas las mujeres con sus historias que hemos tenido con migración. Queremos una ciudadanía justa que pare las deportaciones.
We participated as a group in a fast, a 24-hour fast that started at 9 a.m. yesterday and finished today at 9:30, and we came immediately to this action. We also made a banner that symbolized our experiences and what our families are going through, and we're asking for legalization and a just and dignified life. Yeah.
Participamos más de 35 mujeres que estuvimos ahí, que dejaron a sus niños en su casa y estuvimos haciendo más actividades, viendo películas y estuvimos ahí contando historias y todo fue muy bonito y queremos que todos estemos unidos para decirle a Obama que pare las deportaciones.
In this fast, and we supported each other, we told stories, we watched films together while our children waited for us at home, and we want to send a strong message to Obama, stop the deportation.
He tried to find a way out, but it was too late. The unforgiving grass and the ice cold Hampton killed on my mother's spine. Rosa was the fear of losing mi madrecita linda, my everything. She was the one who cradled me at night and took me away from the violence of my father with nothing in her pocket but love. She was the one that crossed rivers on tires to give me a better life. She was the one that worked every holiday you could imagine to be sure I had three meals and a warm bed. And you? You bring me to her protective arms, and not for what? For trying to make ends meet? For having enough warmth in her heart to take care of her, to feel the best way she could? For being a mother? You tell me what my raza feels every day trying to cross these borders. I will never forget the day, a cold day, a bitch-ass cop took my mother away. Where I'm from, I call you a bitch-ass, you say that you don't have a great bone in your body. It means you are weak, and your actions are weak. I know bitch is a word that contributes to the trauma that I, as a woman, have to endure. But even that, I'll call that cop a bitch-ass. I'll call him weak in the words I was taught to use, in the words that my community understands. He is, he was, and always will be a bitch-ass in my eyes. And no matter how much I yelled and tugged on your bitch-ass, you wouldn't let her go. I lost her. I was 24. Sitting in a bottle to keep me calm, sitting here in my mommy's arms. I remember very well, saying to myself, what are we going to do now? No mother, no father. Just my 7-year-old abuelita, pobrecita, con sus astrices, with an empty wallet and two hands that still needed her, needle stabbing her each time she moves it. And these two hands now have to hold a family of five together. While four children crying every day in a two-bedroom house on 100 in Walnut. Missing the one woman who sacrificed so much to give us so little. She fought her detention. She fought her deportation. She won her asylum. You cannot keep us apart. You aren't even important. I am no longer afraid. I will not live in the shadow. I know I am not alone. We stand shoulder to shoulder. We are more than 11 million strong. We remember very fucking well. Español para que se den una idea de lo que estaba hablando. ¿Cómo pudiera olvidar?
Children, and I'm a mother, I'm a worker, and every
every day I try to support my husband to provide for my family. Mi familia es
desde el día 29 de mayo del 2013, estamos con orden de deportación, nosotros los padres, los dos, y hoy estamos aquí luchando por nuestros hijos. Les pido a todos que nos unamos porque nuestros hijos merecen todo en este país. Y todos unidos vamos a lograr que paren las deportaciones.
We're going through something very difficult in our family. Since May 29, 2013, we have an order of deportation against us, both me and my husband, and we're fighting to stay united with our children. So that's why we're here today. We need your support.
And they're all being treated bad, not like human. And this is my little sister. She's 6 years old, and she misses my other sister that is 19 years old. My name is Jessica. My sister's name is Jessica, and this is Jennifer. And we are trying to get everyone back, and we want Obama and Pelosi to help us bring the 150 families back home. And my sister Jessica is a dreamer. She's been here since she was 8 years old, and she went to Livermore High School. She also went to Las Positas College in Livermore, and she deserves to come back. And okay, so mi hermana Jessica Barragán está detenida en Arizona y ha estado allí por 22 días y la última vez que hablamos con ella nos dijo que en Arizona les están dando agua jugosa y les están dando comida quemada y todas las mujeres de ahí las están tratando mal y hay gente ahí adentro que también está embarazada y queremos que Obama y Pelosi traigan a todas las familias para su casa y son 150 familias que necesitan regresar a su casa.
Hi, my name is Jenny. I miss my sister Jessica.
Oh my God.
I want her to come home.
Él es de uno de los países más pequeños del mundo que se llama Fiji Y él ha luchado por su comunidad por años, más de 10 años, en contra de las deportaciones de su propia comunidad. Y hasta le han amenazado de meterlo a la cárcel por su conducta en las cortes, luchando por esas familias. Y quería mandarle, le quiere mandar un mensaje a Obama que debe de parar con las deportaciones.
Just a few years ago, there was a family of 16. It was the couple, husband and wife. It was the husband's parents. It was the husband's sister. It was the husband's wife. It was the husband's and wife's children. They were deported. And today I would like to inform all of us and let the Mr. President know that the scar that has been inflicted on these people, it can never be erased again. And number two,
él recuerda una familia de 16 personas que hace 2 años deportaron a todos, la esposa, el esposo y los niños. Y quiere decirle al presidente Obama que esa herida y ese trauma que causa la deportación no se puede borrar.
As we do counseling to the Pacific Islanders, as I already said before, the scar, I would like to inform the Mr. President that the scar that has been inflicted not on animals but human beings like you and like me. Why don't we give a big hand today? And I know, as I hear some of you are speaking, you went through the same scar that we are going through. So please, Mr. Obama, let's stop this deportation and bring our families back to this beautiful country.
Dice, no somos animales, somos humanos, y este es un trauma que no se borra. Entonces queremos que pare las deportaciones.
And lastly, thank you for this all solidarity as we stand here today. And the families, not only the Pacific Islanders, not only from Fiji, but all of us here, let's hold hands together and keep on this moving, that one day our prayers going to be answered. Thank you so much. God bless America. God bless everybody.
Muchas gracias a todos. Thank you to everyone. We're going to pass it off to our last speaker, Rabbi Rothbaum. Thank you so much for coming.
My name is Rabbi Mike Rothbaum. I'm an Oakland resident. I'm here with Bend the Ark. I represent thousands of Bay Area Jews who stand in solidarity with those who struggle to find a path to American citizenship. This picture that Reverend Lee holds, this shows my family's path to citizenship. Way in the back, on the right, is my great aunt Rose, sitting with Jewish sisters, garment workers, immigrants, workers with my grandmother, their brothers and sisters. Why are they here? Why did they come? Because this country promised a fair wage, open doors, a new life.
Solo quería compartir el apoyo de la comunidad judía. Y esta es una imagen, una foto de mi familia. Y están en comunidad con sus hermanas y llegaron a este país buscando una vida digna y justa.
10 days from now, Jews all over the world will celebrate the foundation story of our people. It's called Passover, the Exodus from Egypt. It is an immigrant story. Jews all over the world will read the ancient words from the book of Deuteronomy. Aramim, Obed, Avi. My father was a wandering Aramean. My father was a fugitive Aramean.
En 10 días se va a celebrar un día festivo para la comunidad judía que se llama Passover. Y ese es el reconocimiento de cuando los judíos se tuvieron que salir de Egipto. Es una historia de liberación.
The Exodus story is our story. An immigrant group, guest workers in a foreign land. They are oppressed. They are underpaid. They are forced to labor under the most brutal of conditions. Despite their labor, it's all there. You're all there.
Textos de los inmigrantes y la historia sigue igual, siempre buscan algo mejor y sufren más.
The Passover story wakes us up. It reminds us that God cares deeply about the immigrant, about the least powerful. It reminds us, my father was a fugitive. Wherever we stand, we are standing with fugitives. Wherever fugitives stand, we stand with you.
Esta historia nos recuerda que Dios ama, siempre ha amado a los inmigrantes y a los que han tenido que viajar largas distancias.
When we discriminate, when we support, when we turn a blind eye to the deportations that tear families apart, when we buy cheap lettuce and tomatoes and forget the farm worker that made a poverty wage system. When we look the other way as hardworking communities are harassed and scrutinized right under the eye of Lady Liberty, suspects on lockdown in the land of the free, we are reminded, my father was a wandering fugitive. How can I shrink in the face of the ugly shouts and the suspicion at my immigrant neighbor? There are no secret whisperers here. We don't hide who we are. The Passover story tells us my father was a fugitive Aramaean, or in my case, my aunt was a fugitive Polish Jew. How about people here? Was your father a fugitive Nicaraguan or a wandering Mandarin? Where did your family come? Shout it out.
Familia nos ve como inmigrantes, como fugitivos. Entonces, si pueden decir al país de donde vino su familia, grita el país, grita el país.
Or maybe, Mr. Obama, your father was a wandering Kenyan. The difference between us here today and the forces of hate is that we celebrate your Kenyan father and our Mexican mother. We celebrate the beauty of every mother and father and tia and kobi and hermano and mime who make this nation as beautiful as it is, who light the lamp on Lady Liberty.
Queremos recordarle al presidente Obama que su propio papá es de Kenia, de otro país, y queremos celebrar todos los países de donde somos, nuestras familias, las tías, todas las personas que hacen nuestra familia.